The following program is made possible by the friends and partners of Daniel Fusco Ministries.
Hey everybody, Daniel Fusco here. I love that I was born and raised in America. I'm proud to be an American. And us as Americans, we love to boast about our freedoms. But what if I told you, yeah, you, that you're not free at all? You might be like, what? Hey Fusco, come on, I could do what I wanna do. I could say what I wanna say. But what if I told you that that isn't real freedom? Real freedom is something that brings peace. Are you the kind of person who, when money is tight, you have a peaceful heart knowing that it's gonna get taken care of? Do you have the kind of peace that you know beyond a shadow of a doubt that the best is yet to come? What I can tell you is that peace only comes from one place, and I wanna tell you about where it comes from today. So are you ready to get real with Daniel Fusco? Well then, come on. So my littlest one, Annabelle, we like to call her the ham at home because she's got such a fun personality, and I wonder if a lot of it is because she's got two older siblings. And so Annabelle, she's at that stage of being a young lady where she's in like the bag lady stage, you know, like where it's like every purse, everything that's got handles, she wants to hold them all at the same time. You know, and so what's really funny is that like she'll be walking and then she's got like her little like princess high heel shoes that she wears. So she's got these high heel shoes that are too big for her feet and she's got like 9 bags and she's like walking and it's super fun. But what we realize is that one of the reasons she likes all those bags is because she's also a thief, you know. And so she's always stealing something from someone. And so her new thing lately has been my wallet. You know, which is terrifying and probably prophetic as well. You know what I mean? Like as just a young lady where it's like, you know, I'm going to be spending all my money on her. But it's so funny because she'll walk into my office and she'll have stolen my wallet and she'll have it in her shirt and she'll walk in like this. You know, she's got this face and I'm like, what do you have there? And she's like, I have your wallet, you know? And I'm like, well, I might need that back, please. Thank you very much. Now, the reason I bring up this story is not because I just love telling stories about my little Annabelle because she's so cute, but because in the context of being part of my family and being 2 years old, I don't call the cops if she's stealing my wallet. But if somebody else were to come in my house, right, and they come in and they're wearing, you know, princess high heels and they're stealing everything, right, like we're gonna have the law enforcement folks are gonna come over and for a visit, right? Why? Because there's a difference between being a family member and being an outsider. And in a lot of ways, the teachings of Jesus really cares about this. See, he is interested. He came and he lived and he died because God's not interested in humanity being outsiders, but he wants them to be family members. Because when you're part of a family, things are different than when you are just somebody on the outside. So I want you to open up in your Bibles to Matthew chapter 17, verse 24. Now, when they had come to Capernaum, those who received the temple tax came to Peter and said, "Does your teacher not pay the temple tax?" And he said, "Yes." And when he had come into the house, Jesus anticipated him. Now, what does this teach us? My friends, conflict brings clarity. See, these people who are collecting the temple tax, you can almost tell by their question that they're trying to catch Jesus. They're trying to make sure that they can pin Jesus down, that he is really not the great guy that everyone thinks he is, but he's just one of those type of people. Does your teacher not pay the temple tax? You ever have those questions from somebody where someone's just looking for fault? They're just looking for a reason to get upset. Is this not the way that you do it? Right? Because we live in a negative culture, we're always trying to figure out who's the nasty one. Why are they so nasty? Why are you doing what I want you to do? All this stuff, right? But what's amazing is it's in this little situation that's a small amount of conflict that all of a sudden Jesus is going to bring clarity to Peter about how this thing all works. See, the temple tax is really not what's important, but the temple tax and the conflict over does Jesus pay the temple tax is going to lead to some teaching and some understanding that only happens through the conflict. And that's why, listen, I wrote my book honestly about this, because for so many of us, life is messy, and it's exceedingly messy. It's perplexingly messy. Life doesn't get, like when you follow Jesus, life doesn't become unmessy. All of a sudden you realize how extraordinarily messy it actually is. But the reality happens is like, how do I move through a messy world and not become embittered? When everything doesn't go right, when everything happens that it's not the way that I want it to, how do I work this thing out? How do I continue to live in such a way that honors the fact that everything doesn't make any sense, but that Jesus is real? And what I have found is that the messiness of life brings clarity, that the conflicts that go on, if you're willing to allow the Lord to minister into the midst of the conflict, you begin to see things that you would never have known, because it's the conflict that jars everything out of place so you can see what's in your heart. I'll never forget this. I remember I grew up in a family, and I was loved extraordinarily as a child. Like I have an amazing family, but my parents did not get along very well. They were like two really strong type A people, you know, and all Italian. So they were thick-headed, you know. It's like they were like, man, and they would like fight. They could fight over anything. It was amazing, you know. And it's like, and I remember when I got married, I was like, I'm never going to fight with Lynn. Why are you guys laughing? But like, I was just like, I'm just not gonna fight with that girl. You know what I mean? Like, I watched my parents fight and that's no good. And so I remember, you know, like we got married, and I remember, and in my heart I said, I don't ever wanna intentionally hurt my wife. And I'll never forget it. We must've been married about 4 months and something was going on. And I remember I said something, and it was like, it was one of those things that you say that's, it's aimed at hurting somebody. And I remember I got in the car, and she was upset, rightfully so. And I was proud. And so I was not talking, you know? And I remember later on that day, I ended up calling a friend of mine who was a pastor. And I said, hey, can we talk for a couple minutes? And he said, yeah. He's like, what's up? And I told him the story. And he said, you know, praise God. Excuse me? He's like, at least now you know what's in your heart. And you can work from there. And it made me stop for a second, because it was like, whoa. Like, I wasn't quite ready for that response. You know, maybe I was hoping for like, yeah, you're a knucklehead, you better go apologize to her. And, you know, or maybe like, you were right to be angry or something, you know. But his response was, now you know it's in your heart. And we can work from there. And see, that's the idea that conflict brings clarity. Oftentimes the things that are rubbing, the friction points are the things that if you're allowing Jesus to do a work in the midst of your heart, the friction point will be something that now all of a sudden you're going to get insight through it. See, what goes on here is they're trying to catch Peter and Jesus. And notice Peter's response is, yes, he does. And then notice it says, and when he had come into the house, Jesus anticipated him. Now, I love that about Jesus, right? Where Jesus already knows what's going down. And so before Peter says anything, Jesus is already speaking to him, right? Look what Jesus says. He says, what do you think, Simon? From whom do the kings of the earth take customs or taxes? From their sons or from strangers? And Peter said to him, from strangers. Jesus said to him, then the sons are free. Now this is powerful, because what we learn here is that family brings freedom. See, family brings freedom. In an environment where a king is a sovereign over a land, the princes and the princesses, they didn't have to pay the taxes. Everybody else did. So Jesus is using it, saying, listen, he says, Peter, what do you think? Do the kings of the earth, who do they take their customs from? Or their taxes from, their sons or from strangers? Peter's like, of course, from strangers. And Jesus is like, oh yeah, then the sons are free. See, this is so important, because the point is that as part of the family, You now are free to function however you want. You are not under the obligation that a stranger would be. And this reminds us of John chapter 8. In verse 32, it says, "And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." And then in verse 35 and 36 of John 8, Jesus says, "And a slave does not abide in the house forever, but a son abides forever. Therefore, if the son makes you free, you shall be what? Free indeed." And this is the thing. God is inviting every single human being to be part of his family, right? And that way into the family comes by putting your faith and trust in Jesus. In the same way, if someone, if you got adopted into someone's family, right, they fill out all the paperwork, and then you have to choose to show up into that family, right? And so part of this freedom is the freedom to respond to the invitation. Now, I think if you're here today, and you are a follower of Jesus, then you need to realize that you have freedom because you're a part of the family. Now, that doesn't mean that you shouldn't pay your taxes. You realize that, right? You realize that Jesus is using an example. If you don't pay your taxes, we will come visit you in jail, you know? But pay your taxes. I mean, it's like Paul has other verses about that kind of stuff. But the idea here is that there is a freedom that comes when you become part of a family. And if you are here today and you are a Christian, I want to remind you of Galatians 5, verse 1. "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty by which Christ has made us free, and do not be entangled again with a yoke of bondage."
Stepping out in blind faith isn't something that's practiced much today. Trusting God with a big career move, or stepping into or out of a relationship, or following your dreams can be, well, scary. You get trapped by questions like, am I good enough? Do I have what it takes? But stepping out in faith is the key to release all God's promises. God's word declares that you have the power to break the shackles of fear, to live free with assurance that God is in control.
Daniel Fusco wants to help you with his masterful three-part series, You Only Live Once, where you'll discover biblical boldness like never before. This series represents over 3 hours of biblical wisdom and pure grit destined to rock your world. Next, you'll receive the single message, Living Free, to instill the godly confidence to win every single day. Also, as part of today's special TV offer, Daniel will include a full-length copy of the teaching you heard today. Free indeed. Stop being a slave to situations like financial ruin, bad relationships, emotional hurt, and so much more. Lastly, you'll also get as a bonus this handcrafted leather bracelet embossed with the real logo, created especially for friends of Daniel Fusco Ministries. Wear it with pride to share your commitment to keep it real with Jesus. This collection will set you free and change the course of your life forever. All 4 items for your ministry gift of just $40.
It's time to live free and know that God is in control. Act now to get this exclusive TV offer. Ministry agents are standing by. And remember, your gift today to Daniel Fusco Ministries allows us to reach the world with the message that Jesus is real. This is Daniel's personal passion, and your gift makes it all happen. Don't wait. Call or go online now.
Stand strong in the freedom by which Jesus has made you free, and don't allow yourself to get caught up again in something that brings you into bondage. Now, that is an encouragement, isn't it? And it's a challenge, because if you're a follower of Jesus and you're here today, you realize that you need to work to stand fast so that you don't get caught up in the yoke of bondage again. Right? Every single day, each one of us makes all sorts of decisions, and all those decisions have consequences. And if we're not careful, we can love Jesus and get ourselves all bound up again. And unfortunately, there's many of us who are going through that right now, where it's like you are not standing in the liberty by which Christ has made you free, but you're allowing yourself to get entangled again. And you think about that word entangled, it speaks about getting caught in a net, right? And so we have to make sure that the decisions that we make do not cause us to be suffocated once again by things that hold us back. Now, if you're here today and you've never put your faith and trust in Jesus, here's the thing. Why would you not want to be a family member of the true and living God who created and sustains you and everything when the invitation is there? Why would you want to remain a stranger? See, I asked you that question because in my own journey, I didn't grow up in a Christian home, and so I didn't grow up with this stuff, and I remember having these discussions with myself. Like, I started reading, and I'm like, so if God is real, and God is inviting me to be a part of his family, why wouldn't I want to be part of God's family? And then all the reasons why I didn't want to be part of God's family starts playing out. Well, if you do that, then you can't do this anymore. You got to stop doing this. You got to stop doing this. And hey, this thing probably isn't okay in that house, you know, and you go through all the things. But then you know what I realized? As I started thinking about each one of those, I started thinking to myself, well, does that actually really bring me joy anyway? It's the power of the right questions. I mean, I feel blessed because it was the Spirit of God working in my heart that all of a sudden these questions start popping up like, so if I'm following Jesus, I probably can't go out and just be hammered all the time. Well, is it fun being hammered? Well, it was fun when I first started, but now it's just kind of like, it's just kind of what I do, and it's kind of boring, and, you know, it never felt as good as the first time, you know? And I'm spending a lot of money. You know, so you start going down the list, and then you're like, oh, yeah, let's not talk about the hangovers and, the, you know, like the space case for a week after it's over and the whole nine, you know. I started going down the list, and what I realized is that the decisions that I were making were actually not getting me what I was hoping to. It was an attempt at a momentary fix of something that was way greater than a momentary fix can handle. And I say that to you all because I know that a lot of you know exactly what I'm talking about because you've been on that same journey. So if you're here today and you've never put your faith and trust in Jesus, I can't fathom why you wouldn't want to be part of the family of God. If you're not a Christian, you should be. Not because I want you to be, but because you want to be a family member of the Most High God, and you want the freedom that comes from being in that family. It's like, it's so good. I'm going to invite the worship team to come on out as I close this out, but look at verse 27. Jesus is wild to me. That's what I love about Jesus. Because look what he says in verse 27. He says, nevertheless, lest we offend them, go to the sea, cast in a hook, and take the fish that comes up first. And when you have opened its mouth, you will find a piece of money. Take that and give it to them for me and you. See, Jesus is crazy, right? See, like, people say, oh, man, the Bible's boring. I'm like, no, you're boring. This is awesome. Like, it's like, well, you can't make this stuff up. You know, it's like, so Jesus says, look, you're free. We don't have to pay the temple tax. We're part of God's family. I'm the Son of God. Like, this is fine, right? But he says, nevertheless, lest we offend them, I want you to go to the ocean. I want you to cast in a hook. You're going to get a fish. You're going to open the fish's mouth. There's going to be the temple tax and pay it. What does this teach us? This teaches us that compassion brings creative provision. Ooh, that's good, right? Compassion brings creative provision. See, Jesus could have dug in his heels and been like, we're not paying the temple tax, Peter. You were wrong. We're not doing that. But he said, nevertheless, look, we don't want to offend them. See, Jesus is compassionate on the religious system that he's coming to fulfill. Right? Even as he's undermining, he's saying, listen, I don't want you to offend them. Right? So Jesus' compassion leads now to this amazing creative provision. And the creative provision, of course, is that Peter was a fisherman. Now, what you got to realize is that as a professional fisherman, right, he's not casting and hooks, he's using nets. Right? So, like, we have sport fishing where you use with a rod, but by and large, people who do it for a career, they use big boats and nets, right? Is that true? That's pretty true, right? So Peter probably never fished with a hook. It wasn't like he's like, man, I'm in Alaska catching, you know, salmon. It's like he's going to the Sea of Galilee that he's been on his entire life, and he's throwing in a little hook, right? So Peter's out of his element, but Jesus is going to provide for their temple tax in the most wild way. Now, I think this is super important. Here's why. Because although you and I are free in Christ, when we are free, we also have the freedom to be different than we might ultimately be. See, Jesus is concerned for the people who are going to be, that word, lest they be offended, it's literally the word scandalized. He's like, I don't want to scandalize the temple tax collectors. So we're gonna go out of our ways to bless them, and I'm gonna show you how God can do anything. And I think that's powerful. Because for you and for me, there's all the reasons you can make the case not to be a generous person. I'm not just talking financially. I'm just talking with life, with love, with joy, with smiles, with hugs. You know, there's enough water under all the bridges to be able to say, I can make the case why I don't want to do any of those things. But then when you start to have compassion on other people, God-given compassion, now you find ways within the works of God to see amazing things happen. And guess what? When you choose to be part of God's family, right? And God in his family, he teaches you his way of compassion, where it's not just about us, but it's about God and it's about other people. Then you say, well, how do I help? These problems are too big. It's too huge. I mean, who am I? Compassion leads to creative provision. See, what I've learned is that when we take steps of faith, the reason it's called a step of faith is because the provision for it isn't there yet, but you take the step of faith and then God in his exceeding abundance begins to provide the provision for the step of faith that we took. But the thing is we got to take the step or else we never see God's provision. You know, I absolutely love this reality that true freedom comes from being part of God's family. Like when you're at home, you can put your feet up on the furniture. You can go into every cabinet. It's your house. You can do what you want. You have more freedom in your own space than you do anywhere else. And when you become a part of God's family, all of a sudden you have this amazing freedom in this world to be the hands and feet of Jesus. I love it what the Apostle Paul says to the church in Philippi. See, the church in Philippi joined the Apostle Paul in the work that he was doing. And listen to what it says in Philippians chapter 4, verses 18 and 19. It says, indeed, I have all and abound. I am full, having received from Epaphroditus the things sent from you, a sweet-smelling aroma, an acceptable sacrifice, well-pleasing to God, and my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. See, know what I love about this? See, the Apostle Paul realizes that when we take these steps of faith, God meets us on those steps and does the most amazing things. But the thing is, it's got to be a step of faith. See, that's what it means to be part of God's family. God invites you and I into some radical things, things that we never would have ever dreamed we would have been involved in. But God, as our Father says, as my child, I want you to go do this crazy thing. And our Bibles are full of these stories, and God wants our lives to be full of the same type of stories. And what's amazing is when God's compassionate heart moves us, then God creatively provides for what he's doing. How cool is that? Just like we saw with Jesus sending Peter to go fishing. See, God was moved with compassion for the people who wanted to pay the temple tax, and God had a great way to provide for that need. And it's the same is true for you and I. When we step out in faith because God's heart moves us with compassion for the broken world around us, God will provide as we take those steps in the most extraordinary ways. And what I really want you to do is I want you to dream God-sized dreams. When was the last time you moved into your day and into your world and said, God, show me what is broken so that, Father, I may be part of the solution, your solution to see these broken things get fixed? That's what happened for Teresa of Calcutta. She saw all of these starving children. She said, I'm just gonna start feeding just one of them. And God did something amazing, and God wants to do equal amazing things in and through ordinary people like me and like you. So begin to dream those God-sized dreams. And what I wanna tell you is that when you step out in faith, and listen, I realize we live in a day and age, contemporary people are too sophisticated to take steps of faith. Everything has to be perfectly planned. Everything has to be totally dialed in. But what I realize is that God invites us to take these bold steps. And what we learn on those bold steps is that we have an even bolder God. That when we take a little step, God takes that little bit of faith and he does exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think. Have you ever imagined what your life would look like if you took the most bold steps of faith? That right as you saw something and you sensed the compassionate heart of God wanting to intervene in that, then all of a sudden you just stepped out. What would your life look like? I believe that God wants you to see your life that way because God wants the life of Jesus to flow in and through your life into the world. But listen, The provision comes after the step of faith. I'm going to say that again. God's provision comes after the step of faith. Some people would say it this way, that the provision comes in the harvest, but the harvest only happens after things have been planted, after things have been watered. So I want to make sure that you get equipped to take those bold steps. I have these resources right here that I want you to get your hands on, because I believe that God wants to empower you to trust Him more. And when we trust Him, we will follow Him. And when we follow Him, God will do the most amazing things. So I'll be right back with you.
Stepping out in blind faith isn't something that's practiced much today. Trusting God with a big career move, or stepping into or out of a relationship, or following your dreams can be, well, scary. You get trapped by questions like, am I good enough? Do I have what it takes? But stepping out in faith is the key to release all God's promises. God's word declares that you have the power to break the shackles of fear, to live free with assurance that God is in control.
Daniel Fusco wants to help you with his masterful three-part series, You Only Live Once, where you'll discover biblical boldness like never before. This series represents over 3 hours of biblical wisdom and pure grit destined to rock your world. Next, you'll receive the single message, Living Free, to instill the godly confidence to win every single day. Also, as part of today's special TV offer, Daniel will include a full-length copy of the teaching you heard today. Free indeed. Stop being a slave to situations like financial ruin, bad relationships, emotional hurt, and so much more. Lastly, you'll also get as a bonus this handcrafted leather bracelet embossed with the real logo, created especially for friends of Daniel Fusco Ministries. Wear it with pride to share your commitment to keep it real with Jesus. This collection will set you free and change the course of your life forever. All 4 items for your ministry gift of just $40.
It's time to live free and know that God is in control. Act now to get this exclusive TV offer. Ministry agents are standing by. And remember, your gift today to Daniel Fusco Ministries allows us to reach the world with the message that Jesus is real. This is Daniel's personal passion, and your gift makes it all happen. Don't wait. Call or go online now.
So we've talked about taking bold steps of faith today. And that's just not for you, that's for all of us. For myself and Crossroads Community Church, every single day we see Jesus inviting us to take bold steps of faith, whether it's through the TV or social media, mission projects locally and all across the globe. God wants to make sure that the whole world knows that Jesus is real. So I'm here asking for your help today. As we take these bold steps, we want the whole world to hear about Jesus, and I need your help. Will you pray about partnering with me? Absolutely need your prayers. But I'm hoping that many thousands of you will call the number that's on your screen or log on to danielfusco.com and begin to partner with me. We want to see this ministry expand everywhere. We want everyone to know, and I can't do it alone. I need your help. So will you join me in this journey? Listen, I love you. I appreciate you, and I love what God is doing in and through this program. Thanks for being along with it with me. So remember, although life is messy, Jesus is real, and He loves us even in the midst of our mess. Until next time, God bless you.